Hello guys, here I am with yet another script for you. This being my vehicle drop script, which the script's purpose being you can call in vehicles by helicopter, and then obviously they are there for you to use as you see fit. You can call them in unarmed, or sorry, unmanned, or you can actually call them in when they are manned. So this Strider over here, for example, is manned with AI. All the crew seats are taken, so it will now fly off to fulfill the orders I have given to it, which is to go for two different waypoints. The last one will be a search and destroy waypoint, and then it will patrol that general area. The helicopters can be a little bit tricky, especially if you call them in like I just did. If you're using the bigger helicopters, it's even a little more tricky at times, depending on the terrain. So I strongly recommend you do this on large terrain, or if they're coming in the same direction of a road or similar. But usually the vehicles do just fine. You can see no damage taken to this, or actually we should do this. Get damage vehicle player. Oh sorry, it's supposed to be get damage with two of them. So the vehicle has sustained no damage here. No total damage anyway. If we jump into the gunner seat, sorry. Okay, it's working just fine. Most you can call in any vehicle with this. You can call in tanks, you can call in anything, yeah. Tanks with a little bird if you so want to. It's not limited in any way. It's not using the sling load mechanism, because that's not going to be able to have you call in the vehicles as you wish. I don't think they can even pick up MRAPs with the Chinooks, so this will be a nice upgrade for that, I suppose. Removes a lot of restrictions. Of course it would be kind of silly having you pull in a tank with a helicopter, but it can also be quite neat. Hello Parker, are you interrupting my video like Guzzard would? Anyhow, moving on, I think I'll give you a little look on how to set it up. Okay, so this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna go into our mission folder, and once we're in here, we're gonna take this vehicle dropper R that we downloaded. We're gonna extract it here, and then you should have a NECI vehicle drop folder, and inside of this one you should have a bunch of SQF files. So we can delete the RAR file, and then we can cut this, and you need to move this into your scripts folder. And in here, then you will have all the files, and where you want to go now is, presuming you want to make the static version of the script, so to say. When I say static, I mean that the code will will be 100% scripted. You will not get to choose where the vehicle lands or anything. It's completely up to the editor. So let's get started with the parameters. So let's start with null equals, because we're gonna put this in a trigger, and then we're gonna do the first parameter, which is the side of the heli crew. So let's do blue 4, comma second parameter. Second parameter is going to be the class name of the type of helicopter you want to sport. let's just go in here real quick. What type of blue 4 helicopter do we want? Helicopters. Oh, let's use a pony. And log classes, and paste the class in there. Alright, so next, if you leave it empty, we'll get a default preset helicopter. Nader would, or rather Blue 4 would get a Black Hawk, for example. Next, we're gonna have the spawn, drop off, and despawn markers. It's where, obviously, the helicopter's gonna spawn, and then where it's gonna fly off and deliver the vehicle, and where it's gonna egress and despawn. So let's make, let's go for spawn, target, and despawn. Alright, so now when I've done that, I'm gonna jump into the, Arma, there we go. Gonna jump into the editor. We can remove that one, and we can choose that. Let's pretend we're getting supplies from this airport over here. So let's go into markers. Let's go for an arrow there, and let's go for a blue for color then. And let's put it here because otherwise I will be waiting for ages. And this is going to be the spawn or ingress marker, so I'm going to name it spawn. And then we need to create the drop-off marker, so we're going to have the vehicle be delivered here because it's a piece of open ground. So we're going to name that target as we did in the array previously. Let's keep that to blue for as well. And let's do an egress arrow, aka despawn marker over here. We can call it despawn. Alright, so it'll come in, drop off the vehicle, and then egress. Okay, next parameter. And this is whether the helicopter and its crew is going to be vulnerable or invulnerable. If you type true, it'll be vulnerable. If it's false, then it will be invulnerable. Next, we're going to want the vehicle class name. So let's go in here and select the vehicle. Let's go for an independent vehicle. And why don't we, for the lulz, go for a PC. Let's go for Amora. And log classes to clipboard. And paste. So now that's the type of vehicle that will be delivered to us. Next is XYZ, whether we want to adjust the position where the vehicle will be attached. So there is an automated position positioning function in the script. It's not going to look the best, but it's going to work for nearly every vehicle that you will stick to the script. So if you type nil, it'll automatically do it. If you want to make it a tighter fit, then you will need to do the coordinates or adjustments for the attach to command in here. I'm just going to use nil because I'm fine with it. The fine tuning is a bit annoying and unnecessary if you ask me. Okay, next, parameter 7, the sight of the vehicle crew. So if we want there to be the vehicle that is delivered to be manned with units, we can type that sight in here. But we're going to skip that. We're going to skip the 7th, 8th, and 9th parameter because these are all related to if you want the vehicle manned. So let's just go for nil, nil, and nil. So we've bypassed all these three parameters for now. And then we have the last parameter, which is code. It's a unique code you can perform on the delivered object. Refer to the object itself by using this select zero. So what I could do is bracket and this select zero, add action. Hello. And the hint. Hi there. So, there we go. Now we have made a piece of code here which will add action to the vehicle, which says hello, and if you click it, it's gonna say hi there in a hint. So that's all the parameters. So ending or closing bracket there. And then we're just gonna copy this exec VM and script pathing over there. Alright, so now we've made a vehicle delivery code. So we'll just jump in here. And we're gonna place down a trigger. Let's make it a little bit smaller than that. There we go. So if we run up here, it'll activate. Let's make it activate on anybody present. And then you want to paste the code that you've made in here. Press OK. And then we're going to need to place a player. Why don't we do an independent, just because I feel like it. In case I get angry, let's do an AT specialist. That will do fine. Alright, so he's player, and let's just go into the scenario then. And when we're in here, we're just gonna run over here, and the helicopter should spawn. Let's just take a little peek here. No, sorry, it's blue for helicopter. So yes, the helicopter has spawned. Speed up time, and here it is. Here we have a little pawn here coming in with a tracked APC. It looks a little silly, but there are no restrictions. It's up to you how you wanna use this, how legit you want it to be. So as it's coming in here, it's supposed to drop it off by the green smoke right there. This script generally needs a fair bit of clear ground. It's gonna act up if you have poles and trees and whatnot in the general area, so preferably use this in a very clear terrain. Otherwise you may experience helicopters crashing or the vehicles being dropped off way off target. So yes, here we have a vehicle. As you can see, we can jump into it. It's not damaged in any way. You can drive around in it. You can jump into the gunner seat. And it also has an add action called hello. And if we click, it says hi there. So the unique code added to the vehicle works just fine. So if you want to do something specific, for example, add things to the inventory, by default the script will actually clear the inventory of the vehicle, so it doesn't come in full of the default stuff that's added to the vehicle. So it's clear from the get-go. But if you want to add things into the inventory, or if you want to add any specific functions and stuff to it, you are very much available, or very much able to. Right, let's get to the next part. Let's make sure that the vehicle that's delivered is actually manned. So we're gonna use the same piece of code here. I think that's a good idea. And let's remove everything from the right and all the way back here. So here we have the vehicle delivered, and after that we have the adjustments of the vehicle. So let's start on parameter 7, side of the vehicle crew. So we're delivering an independent APC, so we might as well use independent as the side of the crew. So this crew will be spawned. When I say crew, that implies driver, gunner, commander. Those are the three slots or seats that will be taken. If there would be something similar to a co-pilot seat, that would also happen. But all of these types of seats, no cargo seats or riding back seats, as some say, will be used. Next is percent of cargo to fill. So how many percent of the cargo seats available in the vehicle that you want to fill with units. So if you type 0, you will basically have driver, gunner, commander. That's it. No other units. This would be very fitting for things like armed MRAPs and similar. But if you want to fill the seat, say you deliver a truck that you want loaded with infantry, if you do 0.5, That means you will have 50% of the cargo seats filled with AI soldiers. Of the same side, of course, as the crew. And if you take one, it'll fill all the available cargo seats. But for now, we'll do zero. And after this, we'll need to add waypoints. Waypoints for your vehicle. So this will be similar to this. We'll just use markers. We can use XYZ if we want to, but markers are a whole lot of markers are a lot easier. So let's do waypoint 1 and waypoint 2. So it's gonna go to waypoint 1. It's gonna be aware. It's gonna be somewhat alert to what's going on in the surroundings. The last waypoint will be combat stance, and they will be ready to engage. They will be very aware of the environment and what's going on in the area, and also engage target. But it's also going to be a search and destroy marker or a waypoint. So they're going to go there. They're going to, and then after they've reached this waypoint, they'll get 10. Was it 5 or 10 waypoints? I can't remember, but a fair bit of waypoints in the general area that they will be patrolling while they'll just keep patrolling the general area, searching for anything to destroy and kill. That's it. So let's end with the close bracket. Oh, we forgot the code, but we don't need the code because I don't want to add it this time, so we can just leave that empty. So let's copy paste the path once again. Let's copy this. Let's go in here and let's paste the code in the trigger. And before we test the mission, we need to make sure that we add the actual waypoints that we decided to give it. So I believe there's a fairly decent marker for that. No, I can't find them anymore, so we'll just use dots. We'll just use, that's not a dot, that's a dot. And we'll call this waypoint 1. And we'll copy that one and we'll put it over there. And we'll call it waypoint 2. There we go. So now, vehicle will be delivered from here to here. And then when it's on the ground, the units are going to take it over here to waypoint 1, and then they're going to go to waypoint 2, and then they're going to search and destroy in the general area. And here it is, we're back in 1x regular speed, or, well, regular speed, I suppose. The vehicle is here, and the helicopter's about to drop it off. And there we go. And now that it's on the ground, it's gonna head off to its first waypoint. And the helicopter is flying away to its egress marker. So there you have it. A very simple way to use static, use the vehicle drop by just putting in everything in the editor. You can use this for calling in enemy reinforcements and the like, or if you have a very, if you have a designated area that you want, that you want to have vehicles delivered to you, basically. But let's go over to the dynamic function. Of course, there's always a dynamic function. So we can now, we can leave all of this as it is for now. We can go over here and we can open up the init.sqf. So actually let's go back to the vehicle drop one. I think I have it in here. No, I actually do not say anything about it. I guess I'll have to add that. What I was thinking of was that in order to put this up with radio triggers or radio commands, you can go into the Niki init and we will add, first things first here, of course, add this piece of code into your init.sqf, and your init.sqf should be here in the main mission folder. If you don't have one, just create one and call it sqf in there at the end, and then we paste this in here and we save it. This means it's gonna run the this file here, which will create the radio triggers. Secondly, open up neckish-settings.sqf, and in here we want to check this little command here, or actually this variable here. This is the units that are allowed to call in the actual vehicle drop. So what we can do here, we can add player 1. This means that dude and player 1 are the only ones who can call in a vehicle drop. So if we go in here and we double click our dude, he has no name, so let's call in player 1. Now he's allowed to call in vehicle drops. Let's go into the script again and back into the init. Number 3, while in the Nicky settings you can edit the channels, see descriptions for channels in there, and that would be this. So these are the channels that are available. Radio channel or command echo will call in a quad bike. The side of the helicrew will be blue 4. Sorry, I'm a bit allergies are being a pain in the ass, but it's gonna be a blue 4. The crew is gonna be blue 4. The helicopter is gonna be a heli light. I can't remember which one that is, but never mind. I think it's a little bird. It will spawn at the marker called spawn. Gonna despawn at the marker called despawn, and here you can see underscore pause. This is basically the position that you click on the map when you call it in, that it's gonna deliver the vehicle to. So if you want it to be dynamic, so you yourself can decide where you want to drop it off, you type pause in there. If you want it to be static, then you can just give it another marker's name, and it will be delivered there instantly. Now if we backpedal a bit, next here is true. That would be if the helicopter itself can take damage. And here you have the type of vehicle that will be delivered to you. All of this can be found here, but just to make sure we understand it, we're gonna add one more. As you can see, the channels here, you have a bracket, open bracket, and an end bracket, or close bracket. And then you have the first channel, comma, second channel, comma, third channel. You cannot have a comma after the third channel if it's the last channel. That's going to break the script. But since we're going to add one more channel, we're going to add a comma, and then we're going to start creating it. So, first parameter is a string. Select what the what radio channel it will be, and then that would be imply Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta, Echo, etc., etc. So we're gonna take the one off the Golf. That would be Hotel. So let's go Hotel. And the next parameter is description for the supplies that will be seen in the map screen. Support supply drop. It's actually gonna be vehicle drop. Sorry. I'm actually having to update some of these things. A lot of these things I've been able to copy paste from my supply drop script. That's why I haven't found all the issues, or rather all the typos everywhere. Anyhow, that will be seen in the map screen. So that's going to be in the little I'd almost like to call it a tooltip, but never mind, you'll see it in there soon enough. So what are we going to call in? Let's call in MBT. We're going to call in a main battle tank. Yeah, Of course, that makes perfect sense. Okay, next side. It's the side of the helicopter crew. Now we're gonna be very. Now we're pretty much back to what we have done previously. So let's go for blue 4. And what type of helicopter do we want to deliver? What type of helicopter do we want to have delivering it? Let's go for a default helicopter. So we'll have a Chinook. Or a Ghost Hawk, maybe. It might be a Ghost Hawk, actually. Never mind. Next is spawn drop-off and despawn markers. But since we want this to be. We want to be able to select where it's gonna drop, we will need to do underscore pause. So we'll do open bracket, spawn. We already have that marker placed. And we want to select where we want it dropped. And we. No, sorry. And we have this marker around as well already from previously. Alright, so next we have Boolean. Whether the heli can take damage and be destroyed or not. So we want it to be able to be possible to shoot it down. And someone is out there with the chainsaw, making sure it works. Brilliant. Class name of the vehicle you want delivered. So now let's cycle our way through to a battle tank, main battle tank. Copy the class and paste it in there. So that's what we're gonna have. That looks odd. I think this is related to something else, so let's go for this one because I know this one is actually vanilla. There we go. Adjustments, if you want to adjust the positioning of the vehicle as it is attached to the helicopter, I'm not gonna bother with that. It's just a pain in the ass. Next side of the crew in the vehicle, do we want crew in it or do we want it to be just delivered as is? Just to go through all the parameters one more time, let's have it manned. So, yes, we want it manned, and then we will want blue 4, of course. How many percent of the vehicle's cargo seats will be filled? I don't think there are any, so we're not gonna fill it. Next is waypoints. We already have waypoint 1 and waypoint 2 available, so we'll use those. And if we want any unique code passed to the delivered object, no, not really. So now we have finished channel. We have now created channel hotel. We're not gonna put a comma at the end since that will break the script. We will basically just save this, and we're gonna save this as well, and we're gonna jump in. Actually, I did fuck up a little bit here. For any empty variable, you will need to put nil in here. Otherwise, it's gonna go a little crazy. I think I can put in a failsafe for that, but for now, just please put in nil for any spare commands in there. Kind of like this one. It's safer, really. So let's save that. Let's jump in again and make sure it works. Alright, we are in, so we're gonna click map. Well, the ingress, egress, everything is normal. So here we have the supports tab, and then we have this little tooltip thing, what I wanted to call it. So here you have Radio Echo, it's a quad bike, Radio Foxtrot, Hunter HMG, and Golf Strider HMG. Hotel is a main battle tank, and yeah. So we'll just leave that. Oh, I'm in the trigger. I'm actually in the trigger, so I actually fired off that one. So that's the one we've created earlier. And it's gonna drive off, do its own thing. But while it's doing its thing, I'm gonna click 0, and we're gonna click 0 again to enter the radio commands. And now we have Echo, Foxtrot, Golf, and Hotel available to us. So let's call in Hotel. And let's say we want it delivered. Let's actually have it delivered over there, just to make things more interesting. So a marker will be created saying vehicle drop. It's gonna deliver the vehicle to more or less this position. So I'm just gonna fast forward time. Okay, so here is our Chinook with the main battle tank. And as you can see, it's coming in. The turret is facing sideways. I think I'll need to do something about that, really. AI typically watch north by default. I think I'm gonna try and do something about that. It's a real quick fix anyway. So here we go, we're going for the little dive. It's gonna drop it off, bam! It's a bit tough for a tank doing that, but it's gonna do fine. It's Arma. Yeah, it's Arma. It's unfortunate that the AI usually look to the north all the time instead of straight ahead. But I'm not sure what to do about that. They tend to look in one direction only. So yeah, we have delivered our vehicle. And I'm not sure if there's anything else I need to tell you guys. It would be one little thing, if anything. Since you have the ability to fill the vehicles with units, there is a settings file for units. So in here you can select the general settings, so waypoint distance. It's the size of the area to search around when reaching the final search and destroy waypoint. So this is gonna split waypoints around in the within the 150 meters. Next here is skill variables. I recommend you don't fuss around with this unless you have some basic knowledge of scripting, because this is you can basically add and remove type skill types that you wanna modify on the crew, and that can also be seen down here, like set the AI skill, so you have pilot skill, crew skill and unit skill. And here you again have it written down so that you can visualize what you're actually modifying. So 0.3 is the aim speed, for example. 0.25 is the aim accuracy, and so on. And 0 means that they're retarded, and 1 means they're crazy. To read more about the AI skills, you can just go here on this link. And yes, you have blue force settings, you have op force settings, and independent or resistance settings over here. You can select what class name the pilot will have. You can have several as well, and then it will select randomly. So if I would take this crewman class name, for example, add a comma and that, now it will, the pilot will be selected randomly out of these two class names. Crew classes, this would be like gunners, co-pilots, similar. Next you have unit types. So here you can enter an array of what types of units you want to be, you want there to be randomly selected to fill the cargo of the vehicles. The first two are team leaders. So the first two should be the team leader specific classes, really. One will be selected as the group is created, and then it will only randomly select among these guys, since it has already selected the team leader. That's it. That's all there's to it. Make use of it. I'd love to see you post some videos on it. I would love to see it in action. And yeah, let me know if there's anything, if you need help with anything, or if anything doesn't work for you, and I'll see what I can do about it. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.